My name's Melissa Permazell. I'm an urban specialist with UN Habitat. I'm talking about the data collection required for a pillar project. Of course, data collection is important in all urban development projects, but in pillar, we particularly like to gather a range of data that reflects people's, say, formal situation, but also people who might not be officially recognised in the normal data sets that you might gather. So we're interested in, for instance, what a census might have, or what other land records and cadastre records might have. But we're equally interested in what happens and what reflects people's situation on the ground, because we know that in many urban development contexts, not everyone fits into a formal system. And this is particularly in relation to how people live or land ownership, how they live in their houses, and those sorts of things. So pillar is, it really tries to get both the formal and the everyday information from people. We also want to understand things about the community, like the community character or the community history. How does a community operate on a day-to-day level? Because we want to know about what the change to the community might be from the impact of a pillar process. So that means gathering both quantitative and qualitative information, and gathering new information about people's everyday circumstances. So how do we do this? A pillar project would suggest using quite participatory processes to gather that information. For example, to understand the whole range of land and property situations, we would propose using a participatory enumeration approach. Or we would also use things like focus groups, meetings, discussions with community leaders around what's happening on the ground in relation to land, property, livelihoods, to gather this range of information. Finally, a really important part of what pillar tries to achieve in a data gathering process is making sure that all the stakeholders understand what the data means and validate it, so that they're happy with the sort of picture we're presenting about them. And this is also a really good way to build trust in the project, because don't forget, how you collect the data really impacts on how the community understand the project itself. We also want to understand things about the community, like the community character or the community history. How does a community operate on a day-to-day level? Because we want to know about what the change to the community might be from the impact of a pillar process. So that means gathering both quantitative and qualitative information, and gathering new information about people's everyday circumstances. So how do we do this? A pillar project would suggest using quite participatory processes to gather that information. For example, to understand the whole range of land and property situations, we would propose using a participatory enumeration approach. Or we would also use things like focus groups, meetings, discussions with community leaders around what's happening on the ground in relation to land, property, livelihoods, to gather this range of information. Finally, a really important part of what pillar tries to achieve in a data gathering process is making sure that all the stakeholders understand what the data means and validate it, so that they're happy with the sort of picture we're presenting about them. And this is also a really good way to build trust in the project, because don't forget, how you collect the data really impacts on how the community understand the project itself.